such scintillating music on a radio show.
Just be careful this summer when you're swimming in the lake or in the river or in the ocean or in the lagoon, because you never know when the great white will be out there. Coming to the theaters this summer, Jaws 19.
We're going to need a bigger studio.
Nice. Very, very nice.
Welcome back to a special updated version of Vegas Unwrapped. Just remember to join us on a regular time slot, Thursday night, 7 to 9 p.m. Pacific, where Ricky Cash will be holding down the fort with JPEG the next couple of weeks. I will be out on graduation tours for my girls.
Very nice.
One graduating the 9th, one on the 20th. Both are back east, and I'm not flying back and forth. I'll probably call in on Thursdays just to say, hey, kind of like where's Waldo tonight?
No, just to check on us. That's why you're calling in.
All right, truth be told.
Hey, it's a good opportunity now that we are in charge of VANR, and we want to, during the Vegas Unwrapped hours, 2 hours every Thursday, that gives us 6 hours to bring on some of the hosts of...
Yeah, talk about who you've got already confirmed.
I've got a few confirmed. I've got Corey Taylor,
right,
who does the show before us,
mm-hmm,
and has been a spotlight performer on VANR ever since she's gotten on the air.
No question.
And we're excited to have her in the first hour this Thursday night. And then in the second hour, I'm waiting on confirmation, but... Koji, Conversations with Koji, and
Hands Off Our Children,
and we had a absolutely fabulous meeting with him about, mm-hmm, a week and a half ago,
mm-hmm,
in another foreign restaurant for,
woo,
us, but we had a good time there. And so Koji, in the following weeks to come, the ladies on Pit Road Racing,
mm-hmm,
are going to be guests. And we got a couple others, don't we, lined up? We were talking about them.
I think you guys wanted to have Joe and Heidi in from Grief to Relief. Great show there.
Yeah, so, you know, we got...
We talked about Jacob's Ladder.
Yeah, that's a possibility. And, you know, the reason why we want to do this is because one of the goals of Vegas All Net Radio, you know, sometimes I'm going to mix up those.
Listen, welcome to my world.
We want this to be a family organization. I mean, we want all the shows to think of themselves as part of a bigger unit, not, mm-hmm, just their own show. Sure, we're going to support their own shows, and we're going to do everything we can, but as a group, we want to have more power to the group.
Mm-hmm.
So if we're going out, or let's say Corey's going out and she's representing something that's dear and near and dear to her.
Mm-hmm.
Some sort of walk for something or
other. Mm-hmm.
I want to see 20 show hosts out there with her.
You know, like we did with Bobcat with the go-kart races for that organization.
We had
5 or 6 or 8 shows represented.
And that's the kind of thing I want to see done on a regular,
sure,
basis. Because if we can do that, all wearing our VANR shirts.
Which will eventually get ordered.
Yeah, but this is something that I see happening. I mean, yeah, we're going to close out 2015 as strong as we can. But obviously our big goal is to, in 2016, to make this such a splash,
mm-hmm,
that if any of us are appearing anywhere, we expect half the studios to come with us.
Absolutely.
You know, and this is the type of thing that's going to make this much more of a family organization, business, whatever you want to call it, rather than, you know, all the crap you hear about corporate or the business, you know, and that's something that we're going to, hey, listen, we're going to do it or we're going to die trying.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly right. I love the idea of the different hosts.
I just want to say, Vegas All Net Radio, it's not your daddy's internet radio.
I think you might want to say it's not your older brother's internet radio, because daddies are still on AM, FM, and satellite.
The final frontier of free speech,
right
here on Vegas All Net Radio.
So, Bobcat, you're a show host, you're a board operator. What do you think of that idea of, and I know what you're going to say because you've already started that. but what's your thoughts in the total overall plan of this?
I've always been a big supporter of supporting other people's shows and trying to get out. And you know, in this business, egos and attitudes can definitely take a hold of things. And that's one thing that I've always liked and glad to be a part of this program here and a part of this whole adventure that we're all getting ready to take upon, because we've all seemed to work together, and everybody seems to get along. And, you know, we did the event that we did out at the Gene Woods Racing Experience for the go-kart thing, and it was great. We had nine shows out there. We actually had nine Van R shows and two KLEV shows that came there that night. John did all the video stuff on it. We raised some good money for the anti-bullying and teen suicide prevention. So, you know, that and the other go-kart thing that Sergio Quintero and I did where we shaved I got my head shaved.
Right.
We raised almost $3,000 that day for the Speedway Children's Charities. And the biggest thing about it was is that Mr. Chris Powell, who's the president of the Las Vegas Motor Speedway, came over there that day that you guys were all at, and actually you guys got to do the play-by-play of the race, and came over and said, what the hell is going on over here? And you guys have got three times as many people over here as they've got at the bull ring next door. What's going on?
It's not your daddy's internet radio.
And then the biggest kick of it was is that the president, Chris Powell, comes walking up to me, and he looked at me, and he goes, can you guys come out and do this every week, and we'll move you over to the bull ring, and we'll put you to the... I said, Chris, the hair only grows so quick, buddy. So, you know, but, you know, I think this is a really good thing to do. I think that I think we've got some great talent here on this station, some great shows, very great variety of folks that if you're looking for different style of programming, not to take away from any of that, but let's face it, morning drive radio is yuck yuck radio. That's what it is. It is what it is. Mm-hmm, okay, and I think we're going to step into the future and take information, fun, entertainment, and put it all together. I think it's going to be a great deal.
Infotainment. That's the whole deal.
127 million people were listening to internet radio in 2014.
Isn't that a mind blower?
127 million. And now with car companies putting the internet chip right in the dashboard, like the Chevy Chevy trucks, you know, it's even going to render satellite radio almost useless. Because once you pop this in your dash and it gets connected to the internet, you don't even need satellite. You just can go to the website to listen. You don't even need phone apps.
Yeah.
You just go right to the website to punch in and listen to Vegas All Net Radio. But if you don't want to do that, you can download the app. You can plug it in, punch it, and off we go. So internet, I mean, 15 years ago, people were talking about, what's this internet thing? 20 years ago. Now it's exploding to the point where it's as much an umbilical cord of day-to-day living as anything that we have in our society. And our society wants everything now, 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 quick, quick, quick. It's, you know, yesterday, yesterday, yesterday. But we also want it at our convenience.
Right.
And that is huge when it comes to internet radio and what we can do with the podcasts and archives and YouTube and internet television and all that sort of stuff. I mean, it's tremendous what the potential is. Even advertisers in as far back, well, as recently as 2013, advertisers moved almost over $30 million of advertising dollars from terrestrial radio to internet radio because they see the wave.
Top 20 companies that are doing business like that, and I don't know the current number up, but as of last year, they were budgeting 50% of their advertising dollars towards internet advertising, be it a radio show, a web page, a spot on Facebook, or whatever. But that goes to show you that major companies took half of their advertising budget and put it in there.
Right.
Chevrolet introduced their brand new 216 truck 6 months early. And if folks, if you look at the television, if you see the new Silverado truck, you're going to see the front of the truck, the side of the truck, and the last 16 seconds is the dash of the onboard computer and internet services that are coming. So this is all. And you talked about this. Sirius and XM right now are holding their breath because the saving grace is, will Howard Stern sign on for another 4 years? And there's talk that Howard is leaving and going back to New York to K-Rock, where he came from, because he's losing. Yeah, they paid him big money. But I never knew this. For every dollar that was advertised on Howard Stern's show, he got 11% of every dollar spent on his show. So there you go. So Sirius right now is holding their breath.
Yeah, absolutely.
Holding their breath, because if Howard leaves...
And he can ask it for a king's ransom, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah. Remember the game, G6?
Yeah.
You just sunk my Sirius radio.
There you go. So, I mean, you know, it's just tremendous the direction that technology is taking us and what we're doing. And I mean, some of the things that are happening around us. We can't control gas prices, but we can certainly control electronics, which seems to be a saving grace. I mean, you come out here, two weeks ago was the NAB convention, National Association of Broadcasters. And for those of you who have never been to the Las Vegas Convention Center, between all the halls, was about 100,000 square feet of convention space, soon to be more when they rebuild where the Rio Hotel currently stands, or Riviera, where the Riviera is sitting right now. But I went there 3 years in a row, and you talk about wall-to-wall electronics. I mean, it could drive you nuts, because everybody's trying to top everybody else. All the equipment starts looking the same. You start going bananas and Google-wide, because everything is like, didn't I just see that at the booth over there? Well, no, this is our tweak over here on it. Oh, that's great. Wonderful. Thank you very much. So the direction of technology and the future's now. Forget 5, 10, 15 years from now. The future's now. We're just scraping the surface.
Where's my flying car?
You know,
we were supposed to have flying
cars. The Jetsons
car. By now.
Yeah, right. The Jetsons.
I want my flying car.
There's actually a company in California that's actually putting one together.
I saw that.
$226,000 for it.
Cool.
Nice. Where's it going to fly to?
We're going
to
get one next year.
Yeah.
What was the odds on that?
The company flying car. That's all we need. That's all we need.
Hey.
But anyway, when we come back, let's get into those enhancements we've been talking about. We'll talk about some of the things that are going on, what we're going to focus on doing, what we're going to be offering, and maybe some specials for somebody listening who's thinking about doing a show.
Doing a show?
Vegas on that radio, the final frontier of free speech. We'll be back. All right, welcome back to a special sit-down.
No movie music this time.
No. Special sit-down with Ricky Cash, John JPEG Styles, yours truly, Aaron Phillips, the new...
And the Bobcat.
The new owners of Vegas AllNet Radio, and of course, Bobcat at our control board for us. So welcome back. So let's get into some of the things we envision for the station. I mean, you touched on it a little bit regarding the show support and interaction.
Right.
What other things are on the drawing board for us, Mr. Cash and John?
Well, funny you should ask.
Yes.
We, of course, are expanding our video services.
Right.
Which is going to include videos.
Hence, video services.
That's right.
Kind of like what you're seeing right now?
That's right. What you're seeing right now on this camera can be yours. We're taking one of the rooms. We're going to convert it into a visual media center so that we can do green screens and things like that to help do some commercials for some of our shows, some of our advertisers.
Open the blinds.
Do a little more on the YouTube side,
right?
So that we can offer not only the audio but the video,
right?
And have some fun and let people see what the hell is going on over there.
Now, in conjunction with that, one of the things that we will eventually bring into the studio is a streaming webcam.
That's right,
because it'll be live feed from the studio. People love looking behind the wizard's curtain. They may not want to see what we all look like to see if the visual always matches the voice. But, of course, we've been out on YouTube since July with our shows, so people have no choice in knowing what we look like. But be that as it may, excuse me.
Some of our regular listeners, by the way, have commented that they actually now listen to the show on the YouTube because they really like to see the interaction and the stuff that goes on, especially when we, you know, get out of hand a little bit. They laugh with us because...
Or have good-looking broads.
Because they see... They see exactly what's making us go nuts.
The seeing our reactions.
Yeah.
Well, there's usually nothing better than a visual, because a lot of people are visual thinkers, visual responses, not just the audio.
85%.
Right. And that's visual. A large portion. And that goes well with our sponsors, because if someone comes on and they actually have a tangible product that they want to show the audience rather than just trying to describe it, It's so much better to have that visual. So between video services, an expansion on web camera services so that people will be able to see into the studio, these are some of the things that we're going to be doing here to enhance the experience, not only for the listener, but quite frankly for the show host.
Aren't we going to be doing some late night stuff?
We are? Like what?
That was a question.
Like what?
I don't know.
Well, we're hoping our ultimate goal is to have 24/7 programming, so there could be a lot of late night stuff.
That's what
I thought.
Sure. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
I'm into it.
Yeah. There you go.
One of the things that we're going to encourage our show hosts to do is to get out in the field, if you will, and do their shows from remote locations.
Right. We're going to...
I think that really helps promote not only what they're doing, but once again, what are you doing? You know,
right.
Is this a radio show? Is this a radio station? That kind of questioning.
Right. And it all builds back to that visual, because people see something, they're going to want to respond and react to it and ask questions about it. So eventually we're going to be looking for site probably down near Fremont Street as a satellite studio to the main studio here where we're currently at right now, and provide that opportunity initially, at least on weekends, for some shows that want to get down there on weekend time. Like, for instance, The Commander, Bruce Garrett and his show. His show would be perfect down there on Fremont Street.
Oh, yeah, that'd be a great show to have down there.
You know, with the music and everything.
DJ Bad Girl.
DJ Bad Girl will be another. Axel might be another one that may want to do a special show from down there. But these are the things we're going to look to do to really broaden the horizons of EANR, especially when it comes to, like what you just said, the exposure and the expanse of what's going on. So, but yeah, that's what's happening. That's some of the things that we're doing.
Well, you know, everybody knows that I'm big into the auto racing, and when we take on pit road racing live to the Bullring or out to, we've not actually had a chance to be up in the main area at the Super Speedway. We've been to the Super Speedway in there, but when we go to the Bullring and we're doing the show live, do you know what they do there? They actually have a separate computer there that they plug it in. And while the crowd is coming into the Bullring, to the stadium there,
tell me they're listening.
They play the show over the sound system there.
That's great.
And you know, we're pumping all the time. You know, VNR, and it really shocked me last weekend because we hadn't been out there to do a show in a couple of weeks, and people came up to us and said, "When are you coming back? When are you going to do the show? We love hearing you guys up there and bringing the racers up from the pits and talking with them and everything else." And so it does work, and it does help, and it's really is what's made On Pit Road Racing successful, is us getting out into the public.
Absolutely.
And not only the show, but the station and the network that it covers. And once this phone app thing came in, and I'm going to take you guys, and you're going to lose your minds. When you walk the pits, they all have these little, like, Bose boxes, you know what I mean? They got their cell phones on. What are they listening to in the pits? On Pit Road Racing.
That's awesome.
So I think your old buddy here has put the pick in the ground for you, so now let's get the shovel out.
Well, and I think, you know, you're the board operator for so many of the shows out here. There's no reason why you can't expand on that and, you know, get these other people to follow your lead.
Yes. And I think that is really is what's going to make this thing the big success that it is. Yes, we're in a studio, 1A, whatever, here. It's big. It's nice. It's air-conditioned. It's a controlled environment here.
Air-conditioned? Where's the air-conditioned?
I don't know.
I'll go turn it off.
Did you go? I know you paid LV Energy because we got power back, so there you go. But anyhow, that's my point of it. And to get you guys out on location, you know what I would love to see for next year?
Mm-hmm.
If you're talking about that satellite? As we do a big production Fremont Street for New Year's Eve next year. Wouldn't that be a great thing to do?
Do it the week before.
Yeah, let me turn you on here.
Do it the week before? I don't want to be down there for New Year's Eve, dude.
Well,
do it for downtown. Not unless we're behind glass, heavy glass.
Well, that sounds good.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind being
there. No, we should do, though. You and I should go down to Fremont Street and start doing Man in the Street interviews.
Yeah, we could do that,
there
too.
There you go. Yeah, we always talked about that. Yeah. We just never get down there.
Well,
I got to call into my buddy Vince Neal, too.
Okay.
You know, Vince is getting ready to come on the racing show.
Cool.
He sponsors one of the cars out at the track.
Cool.
And you know what he also has now?
I give up. What does he have
now? He owns half of the new arena football team here.
The Outlaws.
Yeah, I'm looking ready to go see some football.
I went to see one.
Yeah, have you seen them yet?
I was there opening day.
How were they?
They got killed opening day. Mm-hmm. But since then, they're 3-2 now, and they're playing very good ball.
And the big rock and roll in it this weekend, the big rock and roll express.
With the
football team, because you've got the LA Kiss, which is owned by Paul Stanley and Gene Simmons rock and roll band Kiss. And then you've got Vince Neil and his partners from the Motley Crue. So it's Kiss and Motley Crue coming to battle this weekend.
Wild. Yeah. Too bad I'll be out of town by then. So. Interesting. A lot of dichotomy that goes in this town in terms of connections and what's happening and moving forward. So
one of the other big pushes that we plan on doing is presently we're sitting between 30 and 35 shows, and certainly by the end of this year, we would certainly like to add another 15 to 20 shows, you know, between now and then, And then in 2016, we just want to run away with it. We really want to fill up the hours. Mm-hmm. We'd love to get, you know, an all-night music show, you know, an all-night talk show, you know, something that goes from 12 to 8, because we got a lot of 12 to 6. We got a lot of people out there who work that second shift. They get off work at about 12, 12:30. It takes them 3 hours before they get ready to go to sleep. It'd be nice for them to have a great music show or a great talk show on at that time.
I know that my very own Bobby Kitty is mm-hmm. actually thinking about something and wanted to talk something about with working with ladies and mm-hmm. teen pregnancy. And so she's working on an idea. And I said, well, the next step for you is get a job. And we'll go pay the bill, and you go on the station. There you go.
But all right.
I think you stepped yourselves into a gold mine. Mm-hmm. I really do. I think within the next year, you guys are going to be really happy with what you did. Not that you saved the station or you saved your show or helped them people with employees, but I think that you guys, like it says, you've reached the final frontier, and the final frontier is where we're getting ready to go to.
Absolutely. Couldn't have agreed with you more.
We had to do a lot of digging to get here, though.
Ooh, boy.
And we got a lot of digging left to do.
Yes, we do. But 12 months from now, we'll be sitting pretty. So
yes, we
prettier.
Are.
So that's good. All right. What other things on the horizon? I can't think of anything else, of course.
You know what? My problem is we have talked about doing so many things and so much that my head is so full that I can't get anything out.
Time for a go-kart race. Let's go. Come on.
That'll knock us senseless.
Yeah,
so.
that was a bucket list item, but I'm glad it's over. My sciatica has never been the same.
It's just getting better finally. No, absolutely. There is so much going on. You know, when you have an opportunity like this, the brain just starts going off because it goes off into all the different direction of things you want to do and people you want to talk to and things you have to put in place. And we keep saying things like when the dust settles, but hopefully the dust will never settle because we're always going to be looking for something to do and change and tweak and move forward with. Opportunities are going to be there to make the business better, help manage the business. A lot of things that are going to help us move forward with the business. And it's just something that hopefully will continue to grow as we move forward. So we're looking forward to it. So
well, and that's something that makes it exciting for me is the fact that we're not letting the dust settle.
Right.
Is that every step that we take shows us a couple of different avenues that we can take. And so we have been, even in this last week, it's been, oh my God, now we can, oh, okay, now let's do this. Oh, wow, let's go down this road.
Right.
You know, so.
Let's try to cut out these big lunches, though. You know, it's the nap time is past and gone.
Food?
And I just want to say, before we go to break, because it looks like we're going to be going to break. Before we go to break, I just want to say something to all the people out there that didn't think we were going to pull this off. And I think you know what I'm going to say.
No, let's
And that is,
where you have
neener, 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 we did it.
Yes, we did. We done dude it.
Well, before we go to break.
Looks like we might have a call on the line.
Nope,
not for us.
That's not for us.
They're going to cut the phones off here in a couple minutes. No. Ray's working on redoing all the lines.
Oh, reprogramming lines.
Yeah, he's going to have it down for about 20 minutes. So, if you're going to call in, you're going to have to wait about 20 minutes.
All right, very good. All right, so let's go to our last break. You're listening to a special edition of Vegas Unwrapped with the new owners of VegasOnNetRadio.com, John Stiles, Ricky Cash, yours truly, Aaron Phillips. We'll be back with another 10 minutes right after this. All right, welcome back to a special daytime Vegas Unwrapped.
Yeah.
Mr. Cash had to step out, take care of some personal business. And I want to let our listeners know, for those who are interested, Ricky's going to take over, more or less be our station manager.
I've heard that.
Yeah, I will be taking over more or less the sales director, sales manager stuff. And John is visual media services.
That's right.
Right?
That's right.
So that's kind of how we have stuff. Now, we're all three of us are going to help support each other in all of the areas, but in terms of what each of us are going to be doing to help manage this business, that's kind of the way we've agreed to separate the responsibility. So if you're interested in hosting your own show, advertising with us, you can contact me at VegasUnwrapped@gmail.com. If you have a general question regarding the operation of the business, whether it's billing questions, or also you can talk to Cash as well about advertising or show hosting, you can contact him at VegasUnwrappedRCash@gmail.com. If you want to learn more about video services or sales or doing a show and advertise, you can also contact JPEG at VegasUnwrappedJPGS@gmail.com. Right now, we do have an office line, but it's still being wired up as we speak, I believe.
Yep.
So, and I think for future reference, that's 702-483-4400.
That's the one.
Is going to be our office number. And of course, but the studio line's not changing, 483-4444. Skype is not changing. Vegas All Net Radio is not changing. So there'll be a lot of consistency and seamless transition. So we're in good shape moving forward there, John.
I agree.
You agree. That's good. I'm glad
It's been a hell of a week.
You know, I'll tell you, I had an appointment with my medical doctor yesterday, with my meds doctor. And he said to me, and I have to go to him every 3 months, so they re-up my scripts and everything.
Right.
So he said to me, he says, so how you been the last couple of months? I walked in and I said, well, doc, I said to him, I said, you know, if the last couple of weeks was a testament to stress and the meds that I'm on, I think I did okay. I managed to still be alive because I explained to him what we were doing, and he understood that because less than a year ago he bought over the practice that he now owns.
Oh, wow, yeah, so he knows.
So he went through the whole transition, you know, so he gets it, but it's just like, you know, I'll tell you, it's been an interesting, you know, 4 or 5 weeks. And again, when you think back how fast this thing all came to fruition,
it's
crazy.
It boggles my mind. I mean, if you had told me, well, that's not really true because I was the one telling you five mm-hmm. weeks ago, mm-hmm. we are going to make this happen. Not that I really believed it, but...
No, but you know what, though? I'm the resident conservative person. I'm the one that...
I know.
You know, if you tell me it's going to rain and pour, I'm going to say, well, all right, maybe a couple of inches, not the whole flood. You know, you're going to tell me that this is going to come to fruition. I'm the one that's going to say I'll believe it when I see it because I've been burned in the past.
Yep. And we all have.
We all have. We all have those experiences.
And there were moments. There were moments.
I mean, it's tough to walk away from opportunities with investors when you're not seeing eye to eye. But again, I have to tip my cap to Lotus Broadcasting, in particular Tony Bonucci, who worked with us.
To help us make this happen.
Yep. And I have to send a shout out to Robin Covey, who is now an employee of Lotus Broadcasting, that Tony has been kind enough to allow her to stay with us for the next month through this transition period, especially since I'm going to be away. There's going to be a lot that you and Cash have to handle, and to have that extra hand of experience here with the shows and with the procedures is invaluable. So, you know, I want to thank Tony for that stuff as well, to allow her to be with us during the next month. And then she will, you know, she'll always be available to us. I mean, we have a call to her if we have a question. I know she'll accept the call, and we have some great people over there at Lotus. Actually, all of Lotus. Jamie.
The tech guy.
What was the gal's name who does the internet stuff that we met the first day we were there? I want to say Brenda?
Wasn't she the business manager?
Yeah, but she's available to us.
That's Danielle.
No, not Danielle. No. This was someone who handles their online presence stuff.
Who really gave us some serious words of encouragement on
Absolutely.
What she believed in we were doing.
Absolutely. So really, the local Lotus office, Tony on down, seeing Jesse Leeds there, you know, who I've known for a number of years, they've really been behind us in having this purchase. Yes, they're in terrestrial radio. Yes, we're in internet radio, but really not competitors.
We're not competing, right.
Which is great. And I think
going forward, we can really help each other out.
No question. No question. So it's exciting. We want to thank all those from Lotus who've helped us make really our dreams come true. This was something that Cash and I set out over 6 years ago to do. To own our own station and to follow our own vision.
And I would also be remiss if I didn't thank my sister and my brother-in-law.
Yes.
Kathy and Rick, thank you for all your help.
Right.
And
Pat Stacey. Want to thank Pat Stacey.
Yeah, I love Pat. She's awesome.
And everybody who's really been in our corner with kind thoughts and congratulations. So, all right, every Thursday night, 7 to 9 p.m. Pacific time, of course, is the flagship show, Vegas Unwrapped. Join Ricky Cash, John Stiles, Bobcat, and, of course, the guest host. He's bringing 6 people in over 3 weeks to replace
him. Yeah, that should be fun.
What does that tell you?
Yeah. and I just want to remind everybody,
yes.
we do have a couple of hours of airtime left.
Yes.
So,
and we have specials going on if you want to do a show on a weekend. We have discount rates for weekend shows, so contact us and let us know. We'll be happy to sit down and tell you all the details. Listen, have a great week, everybody. I will see everybody on the air on May 28th will be my return to the air when I come back from my graduation tours.
Coolabundo.
Have a great week, everybody. From Aaron Phillips, Ricky Cash, for JPEG, for Bobcat, and everybody here at VANR, thank you very much for your support. We love you. See ya.